Viewers to the fantasy whiz coverage of the ICC Women's T20 World Cup. Today we are going to cover the 19th match of the tournament, which is between Pakistan and Thailand. Now this match will take place on 3rd March 9:30 a.m. Indian Standard Time. Now both the teams will be playing for pride here. Pakistan would be eager to end the tournament with a win and a third place finish in the group. Thailand on the other hand would be looking to better their scores and try to get into three figures, which they have failed to do so far in the tournament. Now before we move on to the all important Dream 11 team selection, initially we'll have a look at the recent performances of both the team. We'll also have a quick look at the pitch and ground stats, the all important weather update, team news, and then we will discuss the most important bit, which is highlighting those key players and differential players who should be part of your Dream 11 team. So guys, do stick around to catch our Dream 11 team combination, which can help you win lots of cash prizes. Now let's start by looking at the performances of both the teams in the recent matches. Now Pakistan were knocked out of the World Cup by South Africa in a match where they lost the match by 17 runs. It was a match where they failed to take the initiative after a good start by their bowlers, restricting South Africa to 17 for 2 in 5 overs. And in reply, Pakistan never looked settled and they kept losing wickets at key intervals. A late flurry of runs by Alia Riaz and Iram Javed brought them closer to the target, but it was always too much too late for the Pakistan side. As for Thailand, it was never going to be easy for the debutants, and so has been the case where they have failed to get a score beyond 80s, be it batting first or second. Well, against West Indies and England, they had their moments of joy, restricting West Indies to 27 for 3 and England to 7 for 2 in the initial overs. But in the last match against South Africa, they were completely undone, where South Africa piled on 195 runs. Eventually, Thailand went on to lose the game by 113 runs. Now again here, Thailand were 46 for 6 at 13 overs. But some decent contribution by lower order, they managed to score 82 runs, which was their highest total so far. Now a bit on the T20 history of the venue, the pitch conditions and the all-important weather update. Now this match will take place at Sydney Showground Stadium. Now 3 T20 matches have happened so far and all have been won by the team batting first. The average first inning score is 137 and that of second innings is 110. Now the last match that was played on this ground was between England women and West Indies women, and England won the match by 46 runs. Now if we talk about the pitch, well it's a decent batting wicket if you bat first, but as seen in the last few matches, spinners played a big role, and same can be expected again as batting in second innings become difficult as balls come on slow in the latter half of the innings. So it's basically win the toss and bat first wicket. Now the weather forecast. Well, the weather forecast does not make any good reading. Scattered showers are expected from morning to afternoon with a 60% chance of rain, and that is supposed to increase to 100% by night. So it seems we will possibly get a curtailed match if not the full. Moving on to team news injury updates, where we already know that Pakistan were dealt with a huge blow when they lost their captain Bisma Maruf to a thumb injury, which later ruled her out of the tournament. Now Nahida Khan was called in as a replacement but did not feature against South Africa, and it seems difficult she will be slotted into the side again. Now as we had rightly predicted in the match against South Africa, Sadia Iqbal was replaced by Anam Amin and Saeedia Arup Shah was brought in for Bisma Maruf. Now Anam Amin, who with her left hand orthodox, came handy against South Africa on this solo surface and seems very much likely to continue. Saeedia Arup Shah with her right hand leg break also bowled a decent spell and looks likely to continue. Now well, Thailand, if you look at their last three matches, they did not make any changes in their playing 11, which meant players like Rosnain Khanna, Vanita Maya, Tipachita Puttanong did not get a chance. But considering it's their last game, they might be tempted to give a go to their young off-spinner Rosnain Khanna instead of Wong Pakka, who can come handy on this pitch. Now, we've listed out the probable 11s for this match, and as you can see, we've also listed out the probables who might or might not be part of the team. Now, first, let me start with listing the key players who should definitely be picked for your Dream 11 team. Now, as you can see, we have also highlighted the Dream 11 points which have been gained by the players so far. Now, Zaveria Khan, who now captains the Pakistan side, has been the most consistent batsman of their side. Twice she has got out in her 30s, giving Pakistan a very good start, and scores those runs at a brisk rate as well. Now, she would like to end the tournament by converting those 30s into 50s and more. So, she is a definite pick on our team. Now, Nida Dari is key all-rounder for Pakistan, who bowls well and contributes with the bat as well. She has bagged 5 wickets in 3 matches with a couple in each. Although she hasn't contributed much with the bat, but would be keen to correct the same against Thailand. Now, Diana Beg was probably the best bowler of the day against South Africa, bagging 2 wickets of Lee and Van Niekerk and conceding just 19 runs in 4 overs, which also included a maiden. She bowled well against West Indies and England as well, bagging 3 wickets and will continue to lead the Pakistan bowling attack. Now, Ayman Anwar was probably the most consistent bowler for Pakistan, bagging 6 wickets in 3 matches with a 3-4 against against England. Although she was ordinary against South Africa, she can come good against Thailand, who failed to score big. Now, moving on to Thailand wicketkeeper Nanapat, well, we have chosen purely on her performance against West Indies and England, where she alone contributed around 30% of the runs. And considering that she is a wicketkeeper, she can give crucial points via catch, run out and stumping. Now, Soraya Lathe is the only Thailand bowler who got a wicket each in the opening 2 matches, and she becomes a key Thailand player for us. Sulepon Laomi has bowled well against all 3 top oppositions and occasionally takes a wicket as well, and with a right arm leg break, she can come handy on this pitch. Now, we have also listed some key differential players. Now, these players might not be part of majority of the fantasy teams, but if they click, they would definitely give your team an edge to win most of the leagues. Now, let's jump to the most important Dream 11 team selection. I will now show you a couple of team combinations for Dream 11 that a fantasy based team thinks can really win you some good points. Now, although we show teams for Dream 11, our advice can easily be used on any platform to win big. Considering the pitch that we talked about and the way it had played so far in the tournament, it seems that a team who wins the toss will definitely bat first. Now, considering this, we have gone with 2 combinations. Now, if Pakistan bat first, then we will go with team 1. Now, as you can see, with team 1, we expect Pakistan to put on a big score if they bat first. In such a scenario, their top 3 could well end up contributing 80-85% of those runs, considering that Thailand have failed to take more than 3 wickets in this tournament. We have gone with all 4 Pakistan bowlers, as they all can bag wickets can help maximize those points. And from a Thailand perspective, we have tried to maximize the points that can be gained by including a mix of all-rounders who can either bat or bowl. Now, if Thailand bat first, then we will go with team 2. As you can see, or as we have mentioned earlier, you know, Thailand have failed to score anything beyond 80s. So here we have gone with the same Pakistan players, but we have made Diana Beg as captain. Now, in the previous team, as you can see, we had Zaveria Khan as captain and Nida Dar as the vice captain. Like we said, you know, we expect Pakistan to score big. So Zaveria Khan, who is already in good form, should play a very big role. And Nida Dar, with the all-rounder skills, should easily be the one of the key players for them. Whereas in team 2, as you can see, we have replaced Laomi with Buchantham, as Laomi might not get a chance to bowl a full quota of overs and later can give additional points via batting as well. Now, here we have gone with Diana Beg as our captain, as we feel that she is not only good in terms of economy, but she can easily bag 3-4 wickets in her initial spell itself. So this is the 2 teams that we feel can be placed good, considering the toss that is won by the team. Now, basis your thinking, you can select any of these 2 teams and join your private leagues. So that's it from the Team Fantasy Viz for now. All the best guys for this match, and hope you win big following our important tips. Now, please do like our video and do comment if you want to share some feedback related to our video or the method we use. We would really appreciate it. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more updates on the other upcoming matches of this tournament as well as other tournaments. Thank you and happy fantasy.